Hello and welcome back everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about the for-in loop to iterate the properties on an object. So how we create an object? We just create an object like this, and where we are specifying, okay, so this is an object. Now on the object, what you can do, you can define all these properties. Is prototype of, has on property, constructor and all, constructor to create an object, okay, of the object function. So other thing are the has on property. So what it is do, it is actually checking that this particular object has the property x or not, which is false. It is having property c, which is true. It is not having property y, which is false. So in this, we will create a function and we will try to see if that object has that property or not. So we can write a simple function. Let's write an expression. So there are different ways of writing a function. This is the function I'm writing. In this function, what I'm passing? The object and the property. Okay, and here I will be running for-in loop onto that object. So this object will give me all the key value pair. So what we can do, if the key of individual object is equal to prop, in that case we can just return true, or at the end of this we can just return false. Okay, so what this is doing, it is just checking has on props, that that particular object is having that property or not. And how we can call this? We can just call this is an object. Let's create object first. Let's create an object, and it is just adding colon 50, and here I am passing this object and the property is x. So it is doing the same thing. It is running the for-in loop on top of it, iterating each and every key, and it will keep comparing that key is equal to the property of an object you passed. If that is true, then it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Okay, so this is how we can check that particular property exists in that object or not. And actually we use the for-in loop to iterate onto an object properties. So there are different methods on the object. First of all, in the object function, define properties to add a new properties, multiple property, define property to add a single properties. The entries, like if you do the entries, and we created an object x. Sorry, I think we created objects somewhere past. So okay, let me create an object first. This is an object I added. Now this capital object function has all these methods. Define properties, object.create, it will create a new function. Object.assign, it is used to inherit the properties of an object into another object. Then object.entries, if you pass obj, you will get all the entries inside that function, which is an array, right? Then entries values is another function of the object, so it will give you all the values inside it. You can see there is a single value. Object.keys, values, entries. Object.assign, you can do to create a new object. So this is the new object I'm creating from obj. So it will return a new object. Similarly, there are other methods which we will talk in detail. Define property freeze to freeze an object, which after that you cannot change anything. Get prototype of is extendable, sealed keys, length, and all these methods. Okay, so let's talk all these things in the coming videos.